Now, 4029 weather with meteorologist Ross Ellet.
Well, it seems like 2011 has been a wild year weather-wise for about everybody. Arizona can't catch a break with the dust storms this summer, but did you know it's got a special type of name? It's called a haboob. It's an intense sandstorm generally observed in the Sahara Desert across the Arabian Peninsula and Iraq. Some parts of the world, a haboob just as common as a downburst or microburst is here at home. All of its strong winds. Thankfully, we don't have any of that in the forecast for today. Looking pretty good. Let's take a look at our Super Doppler radar. We did have a complex of storms trying to move throughout parts of the northeast area, especially into Missouri, but nothing here at home at this point, not even so much as a sprinkle showing up in our local area. Temperature-wise, still very warm and mild. It is 77 in Fort Smith, the Fayetteville, 76 in Rogers, and the heat will continue by later this afternoon. The humidity coming along with it, reaching a high today around 98 in northwest Arkansas. Now, we still have a frontal boundary not too far away, but that heat and humidity wouldn't be totally surprised to see another isolated shower storm, kind of like what we've seen in the afternoon hours or the last couple of days. Most of us, again, staying dry, heating up to about 104 for Fort Smith and the River Valley, heat index at 108 degrees, so some incredible heat on the way. But again, those showers and storms not too far away. Here's that complex of storms move throughout parts of Nebraska, Iowa, and Missouri overnight. At one point, actually, we were under a severe thunderstorm watch. But the storms, they didn't want to come into our area. They shifted off to the east, and so far we are left with some dry conditions for the day. A stationary front still holding in place, not really moving over the next couple of days, hence the name stationary. Just not a whole lot of changes in our forecast for today and again for tomorrow. But the heat, that's going to be the big story all throughout the weekend. 100 degrees and plus is going to be very common. But could there be some good news on the horizon? Maybe a taste of fall? Or could it be too good to be true? Well, let's take a look towards a long-range outlook. This hot weather trying to sneak away back towards the west. We're trying to preview really 8, 9, 10 days away. This would be next weekend, but the latest weather data showing a significant cold front could plow throughout the area, bringing the coolest weather we've had since May of this year. Something at least to look forward to. Also, the tropics heating up. And the United States could actually be impacted by a tropical storm or maybe even a hurricane about a week and a half from now. We've got more on our weather blog about that if you're interested about the long-range outlook. But over the next 7 days, it'll be the heat that's going to dominate our area for the weekend. For Fort Smith and the River Valley, 108 for your Saturday, 103 on Sunday, and also about 103 on Monday. Still a slight chance of a shower storm today, tomorrow, and again on Sunday. Otherwise, mostly dry heading into the work week next week. We take a look towards about Wednesday and Thursday, finally a chance for maybe an isolated shower, a storm, and a cold front trying to cool things down just a bit. Northwest Arkansas, 102 for Saturday, 97 on Sunday, so the weekend will remain hot and humid. The air you can wear, it's all going to stick around for us into the weekend. But by Thursday of next week, 93 degrees expected, a little cooler. It's Friday, Saturday, and Sunday that we're holding out hope. We may have some of that cooler weather.
So an intense sandstorm is a haboob.
A haboob. And they get in Arizona every once in a while. The desert areas, Sahara Desert across other parts of the world, they see it about as often as we may see some straight line winds, a downburst. Always something new.
Learn something new every day. There you go. All right. Thank you, sir.